Hey there, measure geeks. Are you on TikTok? Are you running TikTok ads? Well, TikTok is definitely getting a big thing. And if you're running those, you also want to measure your advertising efforts. And in this way, you can identify which ads are generating the most conversions. And by having this information, you can also define your perfect audience and later show ads to them. So let's configure our TikTok event tracking together. To set up TikTok event tracking, you would need your TikTok ads manager, and I'm here right now, as well as your website. And you should also know what events you would love to track. In my case, I have this contact page, and this is where you can find my email and my phone, and I want to track those as one event. And we would also need our beloved Google Tag Manager. So please make sure that your tag manager is implemented on your website. If you do not know how to set this up, I would definitely recommend taking the Tag Manager course, for example, the one created by Julian, which is available on YouTube, and I will attach a link for you. Let's go to our Ads Manager, and here you should click Assets, Events, and we are working with a website. This is why I select Web Events, and let's click Manage. And you can see this notification. In order to create conversions, you need to install a TikTok pixel first. Well, it's like building a house. In order to build one, you have to lay the foundation. And this is exactly our foundation. So we have to install our base, our main pixel first, and later we can create events. So step number one, let's create our pixel. We should provide a name, let's say base pixel. And we have two options, TikTok pixel or events API. We do not deal with API in this lesson. This is why let's choose TikTok pixel and click next. And here you can either install your code manually or set it up automatically. Well, two options are perfectly fine since we are working with the Google Tag Manager. So if you select this one, here you have the Tag Manager integration available, and you would simply have to connect your Tag Manager. That's it. But let's select this option. It does exactly the same thing. So let's click Next. And we have an event builder here and custom code. To be honest, I'm not a big fan of an event builder because we want to implement our events via the Tag Manager. And I prefer having control over my tracking. This is why let's select this option. And don't be afraid, you don't have to be a developer and you do not have to know how to code because we would have a look at a really nice solution later. So let's click next and voila. So here you have this pixel and we can copy it or you could also click this black button. And let's go to our tag manager. And here let's go to tags. We should create a new tag, tag configuration. And we should look for custom HTML. And let's paste this code here. And then the question, when should it fire? So this snippet must be installed on each page of your website. So which trigger should we select? Yeah, it should be all pages. And let's provide the name. We can say TikTok base pixel and let's save our tag. Awesome. So this was step number one, our foundation. Now it's time to create our events. Let's go back to our event manager and let's click next. And here you can see view instructions. So let's click this one and you will be redirected to their documentation. And it can be really helpful so you can learn more about the setup. So here you can see install the pixel and we did it already. And if you scroll down, you can find the list of events you can implement. In my case, I want to track when a visitor contacts me. This is why I need this contact event. And here you can also see the event code for it. But I don't want to deal with code. So what could I do? Well, we will have a workaround here. Anyways, let's go back to our tag manager. Before we do any implementation, we should go to variables. And here, let's click configure and we should make sure that our click-based variables are activated. So you should simply select those. Awesome. And now let's also go to triggers. So in my case, I want to track link clicks, right? So let's create our first generic trigger for links. Let's write all links. We will change it later. So we will leave it like that for now. Let's click save. And now we can click preview. Let's click connect. Okay, so you can see Tag Assistant connected, and I should go to my contact page, and let's simply click my phone number as well as my email. So let's go back to Tag Assistant, and let's have a look what we have here. So you can see number 14, and this was exactly my click. And if I scroll down under variables, I can see click URL, and here we have tell colon. And if I change to number 15, this was exactly my mail click, right? And here you can see mail to colon. Awesome. So now I can define my trigger. Let's go to the tag manager. And here, let's select the trigger that we already configured. Let's click here. And instead of all link clicks, we now want to specify our condition. We say, I want to track some link clicks, and specifically, when someone wants to click my link to call me, and we can copy this even here, and we say click URL contains tell column. We should also change the name. Let's save our trigger and let's create a second one for the email. So here we should go to just links, some link clicks again, click URL contains. And let's have a look here. We have click URL mail to. Great. So let's paste it here. We should also provide a name. Let's save this one. So my triggers are ready to be used. Now we should go to tags and we should set up our tag. So we had a look at the documentation already and we saw this event code. And what workaround do we have if we do not want to deal with code? In this case, templates come to our rescue. Let's go to templates and here set gallery and let's look for TikTok. And this one is an official template provided by TikTok. So let's select this one and add it to our workspace. Let's click add and now it's ready to be used. Let's go to tags and we can define our tag. Let's click new tag configuration. Here, TikTok pixel. The one we have just added. And we have the pixel ID. So let's go back to our event manager. Let's click complete setup. And here you can see the ID. So copy this one, please. And let's go back here and let's paste it. So this is my ID. My event is contact. So you can select the event you would love to track from this list. In my case, it's contact. We will skip the advanced matching configurations for now, so one step at a time. So today we want to set up an event without any parameters. So this is why when I go to object properties, I would select no contents. In the upcoming lessons, we will have a look at dynamic values, but again, one step at a time. And let's scroll down. And when it comes to triggering, let's select our trigger. So we have our phone click, as well as email. So we have this OR functionality. And let's provide a name to our tag. And let's save our tag. Awesome, so now we can test it. But before we do that, we should install an extension that is called TikTok Pixel Helper. You can find it in Chrome Web Store. And let's click Add to Chrome, Add Extension. To be able to access it, we should pin it here. And now let's go back to the Tag Manager and click Preview. So what do we have to do here? Let's go to Contact and we have to click our phone as well as email. And if we go to the Tag Assistant, you can see TikTok event, which is great. So this means that you managed to set up your events correctly. So let's go back to our website and let's have a look at the pixel helper. So you can see base pixel page view and we have contact. So I clicked two times, right? And if you see this notification, the content ID received contains no value, it's fine. So you remember in the tag manager, we selected no contents. So we are sending this event without any parameters. It's perfectly fine. You can see that and you can simply ignore this warning. So we tested our events and now we should go back to the tag manager and we should click submit. Let's add some version name and let's click publish. Well done. So if you go to the events manager, so sometimes it might take a while for your events to be recorded here. So do not worry if you cannot see those immediately. So I hope you managed to implement your TikTok event tracking successfully. Whoa, this was so much fun and I hope you managed to set up your tracking correctly. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and please do not forget to subscribe. See you next time. Happy measuring!